SVK Crypto. We're a community-driven investment firm based here, really focusing on blockchain and digital assets globally. Community-driven sounds a little bit strange to some people. I think really what we realized back in 2016, as I sat at my desk and I saw Bitcoin go through $1,000, after the Mt. Gox debacle, it was trading at about 150. I thought Bitcoin was totally gone. I thought after such a big hacking of Mt. Gox that the whole cryptocurrency, Bitcoin in particular, was dead. When I saw it going through $1,000, I realized it had risen like a phoenix and that there was no stopping it. It took me probably about 30 seconds to put on a trade, and we bought $100,000 worth of Bitcoin priced at $1,000. Some people thought I was mad. Some people still do think I'm mad. It doesn't bother me. It was the right side of the trade. And from that very point of entry, as soon as we put on the trade, it now gets my total attention. I'm now laser focused because I've got exposure in the market. What happened after that one trade at Bitcoin was that we really wanted to understand what was going on in the market. And we ordered every book off Amazon, as everyone always does. We also were aware that these things were going on called meetups. At that stage, they were meetups of maybe 30 or 40 people in basement flats in Shoreditch with tattoos and Bitcoin t-shirts or Neo t-shirts or SVK t-shirts and people with dogs, which we don't see in here today. But what it was a movement which I wasn't really ready for. I was expecting to go to a meetup back in 2016 and see investment bankers, private equities. And what I met was the most welcoming people to the community, the early adopters which had already been mining from single digits of Bitcoin or Ethereum. And it was on that night that someone told me about a cryptocurrency that I couldn't even pronounce, let alone spell, called Ethereum. Next day I came in, I bought $100,000 worth of Ethereum, just over $100. It was also a great trade. You think that that's your love affair over. You got a position in Bitcoin and a position in Ethereum. But actually, I realized that this was now an asset class which was emerging, which 97% of participants in that asset class were retail. They weren't the financial institutions. They weren't the hedge fund, the equity guys. They weren't from the guys that I had come from previously. That really excited me because I knew I was early and I wanted to spot that opportunity like back in my hedge fund days. It was at that time when you understand about cryptocurrencies is that you want to tell everybody about it. You want to shout from the top of the building. You want to get everybody in. Probably one, because you've got the trade on and you want them to buy it. But really, there was more to it. It was a movement. It was a change. It was a decentralization of how people could exchange value and trust with not a center counterparty. And that really kind of hit home with me. So we decided to set up a blog. We had about 200 people that we knew from the City of London that were all in very good financial positions with regards to their employment, working at numerous banks and hedge funds. So we set up a blog. This is the cover page of our blog, SVK Crypto Blog. It's now published each and every day online, and it has over 3,500 individual hits a day, so we're quite proud of that. At that stage, we set up a Twitter account, and we wanted to really follow different devs and follow different funds and different people that were in the business. We wanted to really kind of look at the community because there was no real place to go. So we set up a Twitter account, and we're really happy with how that's actually grown organically. And now we actually use it as a really good tool. Any projects that we like, any investors that we know, any of the devs that we know that are building great products and different protocols, we follow. And in fact, we follow them to a point of obsession whereby I will check every day all the big money managers and VC guys to see who they're following. And once I see someone like Ryan from Polychain follow a protocol or follow a company, we are on top of that, finding out exactly where they're based, what they do, what their website is, have they a Telegram, who else is on their team, and we'll literally become to a point of suffocation to find out everything about that project. So we use Twitter in a way to generate deal flow. It's not just to post our several pieces of content that we do every day. So it's a useful tool, but it's a great tool to connect. So if you're not following us, please do, and we'll follow you back. It was at that point one evening that we were saying to ourselves, well, okay, so we have a Twitter and we have a blog. You know, how can we get the word out more? We're such big audio components and we're such big audio fans that we really wanted to find a way that we could spread the word, not just in London. It was really to spread the word globally. And when we looked at a lot of podcasts at the time, they were going on for like 2 hours. And there was a lot of droning and a lot of talking about the dog and the cat and the game. And we just thought that you could really refocus to have a podcast, not every month or every week, but every day. We decided 15 minutes was an ideal time. Then we realized that Andy Warhol said everyone in the future will be famous for 15 minutes. So we thought that was a kind of cool thing. So we called it 15 minutes of crypto fame. We do it each and every day. We have never missed a day. And we've had some of the most amazing people from the blockchain space interviewed. We're very proud of this. We're coming close to our 200th show. And we're only really getting started. So if you like to listen to cryptocurrency and blockchain technology and any type of market movements, it comes each and every day. Please download to subscribe to it. We're really, really proud of it. It was at that point also that we realized that we had to do something for the London community to bring everybody together. So we started to hold monthly meetups. We've been running them now over a year, and I see a lot of people that come to our meetups religiously. So thank you so much. And we've got some amazing speakers down. And quite recently, we had one of our largest meetups, which was an open panel discussion from guys from Consensus, guys from Switchio Networks, which is a decentralized exchange on the Neo platform, guys from Iconic Labs, which is a big incubator in Germany, and also guys from Iovo, which is a real exciting project which is coming up about owning your own data. Look out for that, Iovo, really, really interesting. And we had about 400 people down that night, and the response has been phenomenal. We do this because we see that London is such a key place for crypto and blockchain, and it's really important that we all come together as one and share ideas and share contacts so that when the rest of the world look at us, we can definitely stand up and prove and show what we're doing. So I'm really, really passionate about that, and really when you look at our events, it's a real coming together, a celebration of crypto and blockchain. So please, if you look at our website, you'll see all the dates that we've got coming up, and we've got some great shows. After that, we realized that a lot of the projects that we were looking at and a lot of projects that we really, really liked were all using Telegram. So one day, we decided to set up a Telegram for the team, which consists now of 7 people, just to really communicate. That Telegram has grown like wildfire, and it now has over 1,100 people in it, all organic. Some of the guys that we have in there are from some of the biggest projects, some of the biggest exchanges. We've got some guys on the regulatory side, we've got some investors, we've got some great projects. But more importantly, we have our London community, so please feel free to get into that community. If you're looking for me and you're trying to email me or WhatsApp me, chances are I'm in Telegram. So if you just post something in there, I'll reply, especially if it's discussing anything with regards to crypto. We love a good debate, so please feel free to let us know what you think.